Well, sponges, pillows, toothbrushes, they are the items we use every day, but just how clean are they? Well, when students at the University of Surrey germ tested their mobile phones, this is what they found growing on them. Billions and billions of bacteria, which can lead to infections such as food poisoning and septicemia. Wow. Here to tell us more about all these weird, horrible things lurking on our everyday items is Dr. Karl. Not just the mobile phone that's a breeding ground for germs, also pillows.
Pillows have got bacteria, fungi, parasites, and lots and lots of dead skin cells, which are then food for little creatures with legs. And there are more creatures with legs living in your pillow than there are humans on the planet, which raises the question of who makes their shoes?
Does it matter though? Does it matter if there are germs there?
Absolutely not. Now, here's a weird thing. You look in the mirror in the morning and you see, ah, here I am, that's Jessica. Only 10% of the cells in your body are there as a result of your parents loving each other very much in a special way your age and 9 months ago. 90% of the cells in your body do not have your DNA.
Really? Are they all the...
They're invaders, yeah. They're bacteria and the like, and they live... on your skin and inside you. They weigh about 1.5 kilograms.
We've got to get Scott Morrison on the show to turn them around.
So they're friendly.
What worries me is that these are sponges and dishcloths and stuff that we actually use to clean things.
Yes.
But how clean are actually they?
No, they're not very clean. What you can do with the sponges is after you use them a couple of times, they begin to get close to smelling bad, you learn. Boil them in water or nuke them in the microwave. The trouble is with nuking them, if you leave it a bit too long, they smoke badly. Basically, what I tend to use is use once and throw away, and you think, that's very wasteful. Mm. Yes and no. On one hand, consider a newborn baby. Newborn baby at the end of a year, say it goes from newborn to a year, at the end of the year, it's beautiful and shiny, and behind it, invisibly, is this huge pile of dirty nappies. You have to create disorder. Create order. Mm. So I use throwaway paper and then toss it in the compost pile and make it, and then use that again. These guys are okay, and these guys are okay, but you use them for a short time, otherwise they get infected with bacteria and then they go bad on you.
Now, what about toothbrushes? Yeah. I brought in one of my daughter's toothbrushes.
Ah, okay. The rule with the toothbrushes is that you use them, they do contain germs, you use them until they go soft and then you throw them away. The germs on them are not that bad. It turns out that in your mouth, the germs on the front of your teeth are different from the ones on the back. The ones on the left are different from the right, the ones on the upper row are different from the lower row. You are a breeding ground for bacteria and there are many different environments.
I'm very nervous
now. No, but they're your friends. You need them where they are, and what you want is the ones that are always there and not to get other bad ones.
There's just one more object I brought in, Dr. Karl.
Undies.
Oh, yeah!
Right?
Are these safe? Are these clean?
Yes and no. What happens is that every time you delicately pass wind, you have on the inside of the back, on the inside of the underpants, you have two separate zones. You have the inner.
No,
enough.
And now, is there any way to protect ourselves? Do you think, is it worth using those antibacterial sort of soapy things and sprays?
In fact, you should not.
Not to use them.
What you want is the bacteria that are already there to remain there because they have lived with you for a long time and they're your friends. We're not talking toilet fecal bacteria. We're just talking the regular bacteria on your bench. Wipe it down, keep it clean, maybe use a bit of metho, but you don't want to use these antibacterial ones because what they do is they then encourage the spread of bacterial resistance to various cleaning agents. And you don't want it. You just want the bacteria that are there to be your friends. You don't want the nasty ones to move
now
in.
Now you tell me.
Tanya has a quick question for you, Dr. Karl.
Dr. Karl, what about pets? We got some ferrets on the weekend.
Oh,
funny
ferrets?
About ferrets. Ferrets apparently are hypoallergenic.
Oh.
Right? And so if you're allergic to pets,
they're good.
They're fine.
There's my ferrets. Look.
Oh. What are their names?
Iris, Ivy, and Bambi Bear.
So they're clean. They're nice and clean.
They're my dogs.
They won't set off allergies, and they definitely improve your quality of life for some people. You know, go with them. They're fine.
I know some people, ferrets definitely improve the quality of life.
And very quickly, the 5-second rule, does it count?
No, they're lying. It's not as though the bacteria, when they see some foodie goodness falling from heaven, say, stand back, guys, we've got to wait for 5 seconds to go in. No, they jump across as soon as the food lands, faster if it's on a soft surface. You know, it depends on the surface and how they
Everyone knows that germs don't wear watches.
obvious. There's a Nobel Prize. We should tell the Prime Minister about it.
Dr. Karl, you are so wonderful and wise. Thank you for sharing your science wisdom with us.
Thank you.
And make sure you grab a copy of Dr. Karl's book, House of Karls. Get it? It's available now. Yeah. Head to drkarl.com.